down her neck. I've done her back with a 4F plate. And her neck by 7.30, but I've already done the 30 on her neck. To do the lamb, you start down the back, straight down the back, with the blade that you chose or your comb. And they go down just a little bit more to come to the top of the shoulders. Then take the dog's leg and go right behind the leg, straight back to the other leg. Not cutting into the shoulder or the hip. Now you're cutting into the hair of the shoulder of the hip. Because you're going to scissor that to blend it down into the longer leg. I've also shaped her feet with a 30 blade, and her face has been done with a 10 blade. And because she's so tiny, it's really difficult to do her. So it stays just me. Feet, it's okay. I've combed out her hair and her top knot. And for the first cut to do the top knot, it's straight across, right in front of the eyes, with straight scissors. It's okay with these. And then I take my scissors, find the corner of the ear. Might be better to put her ear down so we can see it together, huh? April, stay. It's okay. You take from the corner of the inside of the ear to the corner of the outside of the eye and make a straight cut to make your pattern for the side of your top knot. From the corner of the eye to the outside corner of the eye to the outside corner of the ear, just above the ear and above in a straight line back. And then you take your back and you make a small straight line in the back. Then, to make a square, basically just a square. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you take your square and then you work it in a circle to make a rounded top knot. Depending on what length you want it. She's got a kind of a small tail set. The palm is not real full, so I don't want to cut her top knot very full. It should be able to be about the same size. Here we go. Here we go. I'm taking my round scissors now and trimming up to make it round and have a nice tapered look. Going to the middle of the back of the neck, of the palm, by the palm, of the palm, by the neck. Get my words all mixed up here today. White dogs are hard to see. It's just like being out in the snow. You get snow blind when you get white blind from white dogs. So sometimes when you're doing them, you need to just kind of close your eyes or look away from it to kind of be able to focus when you come back to it. That's a good girl. Take my comb and always combing it out to get any loose hairs. Easy girl. That's a good pee-pee. Good pee-pee. Good girl. Good girl. That's a good girl. Lots of them. Thank you. start by freshening them up. Go down to the bottom of the foot, where it really should start first. Push down and just cut off even right around the ankle. Just a circle around so it no straggly hairs are hanging below the ankle. Good girl. Leading it down. Brush your hair up and with your straight scissors start blending the hair, shaping the leg with the growth of the hair or against it, but not sideways. So lengthwise or longwise, either way. There you go. I don't care how you do it, just get me out of here, huh, girl? You're being a good girl, Phoebe. Because the round scissors can really take a big portion out of the leg that's already place you're clipping that you don't want out because of the shape of it. You can go into it, an area. Good girl. Blend the shoulder and chest into the leg. I've come down the chest with a forward leg. I don't know if I said that earlier. Well, it's kind of hard to work around this thing, but I want more skill without my knees, so let's try this. Good girl. Good girl. I can get my big head out of the way of the camera here. Then I'll continue by doing her tail. We're doing her leg, doing her tail, and clipping right here at the plank in a circle, being careful not to get the tissue. Everything's done except for a couple little spots. I'm getting the extra hair off. Right here on her neck where I've done 30, right down her neck, just to where the shoulder bones are, just where the neck starts to widen all the way around. I'm brushing the hair up and I'm taking my straight scissors and I'm just going straight along that line and cutting off any little tufts or stringy looking hair that's sticking out to make it blend. So, here we go. I brush it forward and then keep the scissors pretty close to being straight up and down, just catching the extra hairs. And on any of your patterns, you do the same thing with any of your pattern lines. Blend it in so there's just no real visible sign of where the hair starts or ends. So I'll put a ribbon on her ears, and she'll be all ready to go. And this is the last time we've seen you because you're moving away, huh? She's going to go to San Diego. That's okay. You're going to go stay with your mama's sister. Yeah. You get this little piece. Do not cut behind the dog's ears. Just blend just above the ear, but not behind it. on any of the poodles. You don't want to cut behind their ears if their ears are meant to be long. Okay. Good girl, baby.
Yeah, you're a good girl. Good girl, baby.
Yeah.
Can you stand up? Can you stand up and you get more? No, not too much more, huh?
Not too much more. You're going to take a little bit more hair off on the inside back leg.